Hey, it's SGU, and we are back with the Fatty Butts Road to the Show here in MLB The Show 19. Fatty Butts has made his debut at the AA level, had an impressive 14 strikeout game, almost unhittable at times, and he's getting ready for his second start, which is going to be his first home start, but first, he's going to work on some training, and we're going to work on this pitch type sequence memory. Oh boy, we got a memory game. It's like playing the old Simon Says or whatever that lights up. You got to remember the color and the order, you know, the type of pitch and the order. And quickly kind of lost my way here. I did okay on some of the early ones. And then we fast forward and things got harder. The sequences got faster and more to remember. And yeah, I'm going to have to get better at this. So looks like when it's all said and done. Oh, I missed on the first one there. That's not good on number 10. But it looks like I got a silver score range right there. So I will up the K per nine innings, and we're a strikeout pitcher, so that's good. We want to work on that for sure. And we're also working on our relationships in the clubhouse, and what better relationship for a starting pitcher to have than with his catcher, right? The catcher's on the list here. We've got to build a strong relationship with him. So let's go ahead and jump into this conversation. And it looks like we'll have a chance to work another one of our skill paths. We're going to go Maverick or Lightning Rod. I think maybe we will go with the Lightning Rod. Okay, so now our second start.
Fatty Butts has the ball for the fifth game of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, you always like to begin the season on a good note. In his first start of the year, he did just that, picking up the win. There's nothing he'd like to do more than to get number two in this one here.
So there you see highlighted his first start where he had those 14 strikeouts. Here he comes today trying to do more of the same. Here is a fly ball, foul ball, that the first baseman is going to make the play on. He had to throw eight pitches to that first batter, though. Had to work to get his out. All right, so an 0-1 count to the next batter, and he will put it in play, and that is going to be a single over the second baseman's head. Drops in shallow right field. So the first hit of the game against him is going to come right in the first inning here, the second batter. So working with a runner on now, and he's down 1-0 in the count, and this is a line drive. Oh, extended glove of the first baseman, cannot come up with it. Down in the right field corner, runner's going to go from first to third, and all of a sudden, Fatty Butts has got some real trouble to face here in the very first inning. It looked like a breaking pitch that was handled down the right field line. And you've got consecutive hits now in the first inning and a bit of a jam with first and third and one out. He works an 0-1 count, and then the next pitch is put in play. This time, line drive right at the first baseman, and he'll make the catch. Notice they're making good contact so far, and they're making Fatty Butts work in this one right off the bat. Already 15 pitches, and his 16th pitch will be put in play up the middle and through for a hit. That's going to bring home the first run of the game. 1-0 Jumbo Shrimp. Ah, shoot. Okay, well, not the first inning we had hoped for, as he's been tagged for several hits already, and I'm sure the frustration is setting in a little bit for Fatty Butts. But he does have two outs in the inning, so maybe he can stop the bleeding right here. Well, so much for that. Line drive up the middle, and that runner coming around third to score will make it 2-0 now. Jacksonville jumps on top in the top of the first for two runs, and they're not done yet. Fatty Butts, very much different than the first inning. He escaped in his first outing and then went on to post 14 strikeouts and a win in a very dominant start. This one, yeah, he didn't get out unscathed, and his roughest inning by far in his short double-A career, but there's a strikeout. You're out! The first of the day, and it is a huge relief there to finally get off the mound. Two runs and four hits later, the Jumbo Shrimp jump on top. Will we get any of that back? Well, coming out for the top of the second, the answer is no, not yet. We have a dynamic challenge to sift through right here. Which one are we going to go with? Probably the top one there. End the inning without giving up a run and just one hit. Okay, well, let's see if we can accomplish that. That would be much better than our first inning. First batter and first pitch. Curveball, he's not going to go for. Works this count full, 3-2. They're making him throw a lot of pitches. This is one huge difference. There's his second strikeout of the day.
You're out!
Much better way to start inning number two with a strikeout. His second of the game. Replay in order here as you see this pitch tailing away from the batter low in the zone, and he swings right over it for the swinging strike three. 2-1 count to the next batter. He will put it in play, and I don't think they're going to catch that. Splits the right fielder and the center fielder to the fence, and he's not going to stop at two. He's going for three. He'll be safe with a head first slide. Fatty Butts backing up third base there in case the throw gets away. Now that's not good. He just gave up a triple. So now as far as his dynamic challenge, he can give up one hit, but he can't give up a run. So that's a little bit of a problem because you got a runner at third base with one out. See the head first slide into third right there to gain the triple. What will he do to come back and try to strand him there? He works the count 0-1. And then this ball hit at third base. Nice play. Looks the runner back and then throws to first for out number two. Okay. Quick thinking right there at third base to save a run and to get the out at first base. So now with two outs and an 0-1 count, can he get out of the inning? This will be a fly ball to right center. A dive, and no, he couldn't catch it. What an effort by the center fielder, but he cannot catch the ball. That's going to be a double and an RBI. It fails our dynamic challenge as well. Things not very easy for Fatty Butts in this outing so far. As you see, that's a great effort there. Center fielder trying to help him out and rob one right there, but he can't quite do it. And there you go, Jacksonville now with the 3-0 lead, and problems are mounting for Fatty Butts. 0-2 count. He'll get the strikeout to end the inning. But not before they put another one on the board. 3-0 is your score right now. And it looks like, oh, they got him one back. So it's 3-1 as he takes the hill in the third. A 2-2 count and a swinging strike three.
You're out!
Strikeout number four for Fatty Butts. And that's got to feel good to once again start the inning with a strikeout. But he did that last inning and still surrendered a run. So let's see what happens here. Line drive to right field, going to put a runner on base with one out. And you see these long counts they're working. He's already thrown 52 pitches in the third inning, and he's only got one out. That's going to be trouble going forward as far as your longevity, trying to make it through a ball game into the later innings. Here's a fly ball to center field on an 0-2 count that'll get him out number two. So that's a welcome sign right there. Now he's just got to bear down and finish this inning off. Make this the first one where they do not put a run across the board. The 1-1 pitch is put in play. It's put in play pretty deep to center field. No, he's not going to get that. One hop off the base of the wall. Another run coming around, and they will score 4-1, just like last inning. Started it off pretty good, but then it goes south, and he surrenders another run.
Man, this is just not what he had in mind when the skipper gave him the ball in this one. He's given up 8 hits, and we're not even out of the third inning. He's getting exposed a little bit here.
As smoothly as everything went in the first start, it's about as rough as it's been in the second. He does come back with another K. Strikeout number five ends the third inning for Fatty Butts, but hey, they've put 4 runs and 8 hits on the board, so he's got to be shaken a little bit with the confidence. They will bring him back out for the fourth inning. 2-2 count to his first batter. That's going to be put in play, and that is deep to left. Looking back, and it's over the fence. A home run, solo shot. That's the first time that's happened to Fatty Butts in Double-A. Surrender a home run. Grabbing for that rosin bag, probably more out of frustration than anything, but also trying to find his grip. Man, Jacksonville putting up a run in each inning against him so far. At least one run in each inning. And it's now 5-1 after this solo home run. Pulls the pitch to left field. And see you later. Is that the end for Fatty Butts, or are they going to let him continue in this inning? Let's find out here. They're going to let him continue. 1-1 count to the next batter. And that is a roller on the infield. Second baseman's got it. We'll throw him out of first. Out number one of the fourth. 69 pitches in. Way more of a total than he wants to see right now at this point. 1-2 count to the next batter. And strike three swinging. Strikeout number 6 and out number 2 of the inning. Let's just get this over with here at the next batter. But as you see, as he tries to catch up with this one, and he is quite late on it. So when the pitches are going well and he's hitting his spots, he can definitely do damage like that, as we saw 14 times in the first outing. This one was hit hard, but luckily the left fielder gets out there and snags it to end the inning. 5-1, the Blue Wahoos trail, and I believe that is going to be the end of the outing for Fatty Butts. So definitely not as notable as the first one. And when things are all said and done, it is going to be a 15-1 route. Now, we only gave up 5 of those, but 15-1, the Jumbo Shrimp pour it on here for the win. Blue Wahoos take a big L in this one, and it'll be the first loss of the Double-A career for Fatty Butts. So you win some, you lose some. That is definitely the case, as we've seen in the last 2 episodes here, as you see his line for the day.
A player receives advice about the refining of his game.
Pitching coach comes over to talk about basically setting up pitch after pitch there, the sequence of your pitches, and how that is going to help you moving forward. He just wasn't fooling people today. That's the big thing. So, oh well, on to the next one, as they say. It'll be against Biloxi in his next start, I do believe, if he gets into that series after the get off the bus. And rolling across the U.S. here in the coach bus and Double A. We'll see you next time for more Fatty Butts. Hopefully we'll have a rebound start the very next time we come out. We will see you then.